Hello everyone, welcome to AKN Sprint Education. Myself Naveen, I'm the Maths Mentor. And today's session, let us discuss about important sums from the chapter Probability. Right? As this chapter carries one 2 mark question, one 4 mark question, as well as one 8 mark question. Right? So let us discuss all the important questions from this chapter in this video. So children, don't forget to hit subscribe button, like it and share it with your friends so that I can make more videos. Coming to question number 1, a bag contains 7 red, 5 white and 6 black balls. We have one bag, in that we have 7 red balls, 5 white balls and 6 black balls. A ball is drawn from the bag at random. Find the probability that the ball drawn is not black. That the ball drawn is not black. So the first of all, so what is the probability of an event? P of E equal to, the formula is number of favorable outcomes to the total number of, this is our formula, P of E equal to number of favorable outcomes to the total number of outcomes. Actually, totally we have how many number of balls? 7 red, 5 white and 6 black. 7 plus 5, 12, 12 plus 6, 18 balls we have. So, total, what is our event here? The event is that the ball drawn is not black, except black. Totally, total number of favorable outcomes, total number of outcomes are 18. But our event is ball drawn is not black, I mean except black remaining. Either it may be red ball or it may be white ball. Otherwise, the not black and except black, you can any other balls. Except black, we have 7 red and 5 white. Total how many? 12, right? Totally we have 12, right? So 18 minus 12, which is equal to how much? 6. We have 6 black balls, except black balls. So here number of favorable outcomes are how many? Number of favorable outcomes are 12, because except black, except black we have 7 red, 5 white. 7 plus 5, 12. So number of favorable outcomes are 12 to the total number of outcomes are how many? 18. Right? In 6 table, 6 2 are 12, 6 3 are 18. So what is our probability? P of E equal to 2 by 3. Children, did you understand? Our event is the ball drawn is not black. Except black, remaining is 12 balls. So 12 by 18, 6 2 are 6 3 are. Clear? This type of question they are asking in the public examination. Coming to second question, one card is selected from a well shuffled deck of 52 cards. We know total we have 52 cards. One card is drawn from well shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability of getting a red card with prime number. See, what is our event is what? A red card with prime number. Actually, we have how many red cards? Totally we have 26 red cards. Among them, 13 hearts, 13 diamonds. 13 hearts, 13 diamonds, 13 plus 13 together 26. Okay, 13, that is king, queen, jack, ash, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Here also, king, queen, jack, ash, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Total 13 cards. Right? But our event is getting a red card with prime numbers. What do you mean by prime numbers? Prime numbers are nothing but numbers which are having only two factors, that is 1 and itself. So here, if you observe here, 2 is a prime number, which is called even prime number. 3 is also a prime number. 5 is also a prime number. 7 is also a prime number. Totally we have how many prime numbers here? Here we have 4 prime numbers, that is from hearts. Again here also we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also we have 4 prime numbers, that is from diamonds. Total how many possible outcomes? Here 4, here 4. 4 plus 4, 8. As we know that probability of an event P of E equal to number of favorable outcomes to the total number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes are 52 and number of favorable outcomes are 4 plus 4, 8. Children, if you understand number of favorable outcomes, here our event is getting a red card with prime number. Prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7. Here 4 prime numbers, that is from hearts. Here also 4 prime numbers, that is from diamond. 4 plus 4, totally 8 prime numbers. Total 8 prime numbers. 8 by 52. So 4 2 is 8, 4 1 is 4, 4 3 is 4. So answer is what? 2 by 13. Children, did you understand these two problems? These type of problems they are asking in the public examination. Now coming to third question, a bag contains balls which are numbered from 1 to 15. So total number of outcomes, total number of balls equal to 50. I mean total number of outcomes equal to 50. Is it clear, statement number 1? A bag contains balls which are numbered from 1 to 50. I mean in that bag we have 50 balls. Total number of outcomes are 50. A ball is drawn at random from the bag. The probability that it bears a 2-digit number multiple of 7. What is that? Our event is what? Getting a probability that it bears a 2-digit number multiple of 7. So totally, total number of balls are 50, that is from 1 to 50. But here condition is what? It bears a 2-digit number. 2-digit numbers means it starts from 10. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and so on up to 49.
A 2-digit number
and it should be multiple of 7.
2-digit number should be multiple of 7.
So multiples of 7 means 7, 1 is 7. But 7 is not a 2-digit number. Next, 7, 2 is 14. 7, 2 is 14. So number of favorable outcomes, number of favorable outcomes equal to, they are what? 7 2 is 14, 7 3 is 21, 7 4 is 28, 7 5 is 35, 7 6 is 42, 7 7 is 49. Because the numbers from 1 to 50 only, right? So therefore the 2-digit number, they are the multiples of 7 are how many? 1 2 3 4 5 6. So number of favorable outcomes are how many? 6. Total number of outcomes are how many? 50. So what is the probability of an event P of E equal to number of favorable outcomes to the total number of outcomes? Number of favorable outcomes are 6. Total number of outcomes are 50. 2 3 is 225 is. So the answer is 3 by 25. Okay children, try to understand the question. It should be a 2-digit number and it should be multiple of 7. 7 2 is 14, 7 3 is 21, 7 4 is 28, 7 5 is 35, 7 6 is 42, 7 7 is 49. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number of outcomes are 6. Total number of outcomes are 50. Okay. Next, what is the probability of a number picked from first 20 natural numbers? First 20 natural numbers. So total number of outcomes, total number of outcomes equal to 20. And what is our condition? The probability that it should be an even composite number. See what they are asking? It should be even composite number. So what are the composite numbers between 1 to 20? Because they are natural numbers. Natural numbers means it starts from 1. So what is the smallest composite number? Of course 4, right? So 4 is also even number. They are saying even composite number. What do you mean by composite number, children? Numbers which are having more than two factors. More than two factors. Okay?
4. What are the factors of 4?
Factors of 4 are 1 4 ja 4, 2 2 ja 4. I mean the factors of 4 are 1, 2, 4.
Right? Coming to 5. 5 is a prime number. It is not a composite number. Coming to 6. 6 is?
Yes, it is a composite number. Also an even number.
7, prime number.
8.
Yes, it is an even number and also a composite number.
9.
9 is a composite number, but the condition is it should be even number. That is the reason we are excluding 9. Okay? 10.
10 is a composite number. 12 is a composite number. 14 is a composite number.
Coming to 15. Actually, 15 is also a composite number, but it is not an even composite number.
Right?
16. 18. Right?
They are asking people from first 20 natural numbers, it is an even composite number. So we have totally how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 20 also.
20 also
even composite number. So number of favorable outcomes are how many?
Number of favorable outcomes equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, probability of an event P of E equal to 9 by 20. What is the answer, children? The answer is what? 9 by 20. Is it clear, children? These two types of method also, they are asking in the public examination.
Now, coming to question number 5. From English alphabet, if a letter is chosen at random, then find the probability that the letter is consonant.
Children, question, did you understand? Try to understand the question. Actually, we have 26 alphabets, right? That is from A to Z.
So, total number of outcomes? Which is equal to 26. Among 26, we have vowels as well as consonants. Totally we have 5 vowels, that is A, E, I, O, U, and remaining 21 are consonants.
Here the question is what? Probability that the letter is consonant. So number of favorable outcomes.
Number of favorable outcomes equal to 21. So our event is the letter is consonant. So P of E equal to number of favorable outcomes are 21 and total number of outcomes are 26.
Children, did you understand? If suppose find the probability that the letter is a vowel instead of consonant, vowel adigar ankonde, appudu probability emaitadi 5 by 26. If it is consonant, 21 by 26.
Now coming to 6th question, what is the probability of getting exactly 2 heads when 3 coins are tossed simultaneously?
When 3 coins are tossed simultaneously. So children, let me explain the concept. If you toss a single coin,
let me explain about single coin. If you toss a single coin, what is our sample space? S equal to, you will get head and tail.
So total number of outcomes are 2 only. Okay? Sometimes they may ask, what is the probability of getting a head? What is the probability of getting a head when a single coin is tossed?
What is the probability of getting a head when a single coin is tossed? So you may get 1 by 2. What is the probability of getting a tail when a single coin is tossed? Getting a tail is 1 by 2.
Children, did you understand? If you toss a single coin, what is the probability of getting head? Which is equal to 1 by 2. When we toss a single coin, what is the probability of getting tail? Which is also 1 by 2.
So number of favorable outcomes are 1, total number of outcomes are 2. Here also number of favorable outcomes are 1 and total number of outcomes are 2. Right?
If it is single coin.
If it has two coins, what is the sample space? You may get head-to-head, head-to-tail, tail-head, tail-tail. So total number of possible outcomes are?
Total number of outcomes are 4. They may ask any question. What is the probability of getting at least one head?
My question is what?
at least one head. So P of H equal to at least one head, 1, 2, 3. Number of outcomes are 3 and total number of outcomes are 4. Now my question is, getting at least one tail. Getting at least one tail. So P of T equal to, here also 3/4. 1, 2, 3. Number of our outcomes are 3 and total number of outcomes are 4. So they may ask at most one head. At most one head. So P of H is equal to at most. At most means both should be heads. We have only one favorable outcome. Total number of outcomes are 4. They may ask what at most one tail. At most one tail also 1/4. Children, this is about tossing two coins. Number of favorable, total number of outcomes are 4. Is it clear? But here the question is tossing three coins. What is the question? Tossing three coins. If you toss three coins, what is the sample space, children? You may get head, 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 tail, head, tail, head, tail, head, head. Next. Tail, 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 head, tail, head, tail, head, tail, tail. So total number of outcomes are how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? So total number of outcomes are, let me write here, total number of outcomes equal to 8. Now what is our event? Getting exactly two heads. Getting exactly two heads. So here we have two heads. 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 That's all. Remaining all one head only. So number of possible outcomes equal to 4, right? So probability of an event E equal to number of favorable outcomes are 4, total number of outcomes are 8. That is equal to what? 1/2. Children, do you understand? If you toss 3 coins, number of total number of outcomes are 8. If you toss 2 coins, total number of outcomes are 4. If you toss a single coin, number of total number of outcomes are 2. Which is the concept, right? Now coming to 7th question, which is an important question. The probability of an event is always between 0 and 1. Why? Children, in the chapter probability, answer should be always lies between 0 and 1. That is, you remember. If you are getting greater than 1, or if you are getting negative values, that sum is wrong. Probability of an event is always lies between 0 and 1. Why? Because number of favorable outcomes can never be greater than total number of outcomes. What is the question? First one, number of favorable outcomes can never be greater than total number of outcomes. That is one point. And the second point, number of possible outcomes can never be negative. Obviously, we have number of outcomes, favorable outcomes. So number of favorable outcomes can never be negative. Number of favorable outcomes can never be greater than total number of outcomes. These two points you need to remember. Number of favorable outcomes can never be greater than total number of outcomes, and number of possible outcomes can never be negative. So the probability of an event is always in between 0 and 1. So we can also write as probability of an event is always lies between 0 and 1. I mean 0 less than or equal to P of E less than or equal to 1. Children, did you understand these 7 sums? Now coming to problem number 8, if P of E equal to 0.05, what is the probability of not E? So they are complementary events. So given P of E equal to 0.05 and they are asking to find out P of not E, I mean P of E bar, right? As we know that P of E plus P of E bar equal to 1. You know this formula? P of E plus P of E bar equal to 1. Given P of E value 0.05 plus, we need to find out P of E bar, which is equal to 1. So plus 0.05 you transpose. So P of E bar equal to 1 minus 0.05. So from 1, you subtract 0.05, this will become 10, 10 minus 5, 5, here 9 will be, this is 0. So children, what is the P of E bar? P of E bar equal to 0.95. This type of method problems are very very important. P of E plus P of E bar equal to 1. Right? Now coming to question number 9. A die is thrown once. If we throw a single die, what is the sample space, children? Sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, total number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes equal to 6. Right? Find the probability of getting a composite number. What do you mean by composite number? Having more than two factors. Here the smallest composite number is 4. Actually 5 is a prime number. 3 is a prime number. 2 is a prime number. 1 is neither prime nor composite. So 6 is also a composite number. Children, is it clear? 1 is neither prime nor composite. 2 prime number. 3 prime number. 5 prime number. We have only possible outcomes are 4 and 6. I mean, number of possible outcomes equal to only 2. So, probability of an event P of equal to number of possible outcomes are 2, total number of outcomes are 6. 2 1s are, 2 3s are. So, answer is what? 1 by 3. Okay? Now, coming to 10th question, find the probability of getting a sum of the numbers on them is 7 when 2 dice are rolled at a time. Children, try to understand. Here we are rolling how many dice? 2 dice. When we throw 2 dice at a time, total number of possible outcomes, do you know total number of possible outcomes? Actually, you will be having 36 possible outcomes. Let me write from here. So, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. Next, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6. Next, 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6. Next, 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6, 6. Children, when we throw 2 dice at a time, total number of possible outcomes are 36. Right? The question you try to understand, probability of getting a sum of the numbers on them is 7. So suppose I throw one die, your friend throw another die, another die. Okay? So sum of the numbers on them is 7. See that, for example, here I throw one die, I got 1. Another friend, my friend throw another die, he got 6. So if I add 1 to 6, 1 plus 6 how much? 7, right? So sum of the numbers on them is 7. So the possibilities are here 1, 6, 2, 5, 3, 4, 4, 3, 5, 2, 6, 1. Because 6 plus 1, 7. 5 plus 2, 7. 4 plus 3, 7. 3 plus 4, 7. 2 plus 5, 7. 1 plus 6, 7. Because they are asking sum of the numbers on them is 7. Means if we add this, you must get sum of the numbers is 7. So total number of possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? So possible outcomes equal to 6, and total number of outcomes are 36. Right? So probability of an event P of E equal to number of favorable outcomes to the total number of outcomes. 6 1s are 6 6s are. So what is the answer? The answer is 1 by 6, children. Okay? Is it clear, children? If we throw a single die, total number of outcomes are 6. If we throw 2 dice at a time, total number of possible outcomes are 36. Sometimes they may ask, getting sum of the numbers is
4.
4 means 1, 2, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. 2 plus 2, 4. 1 plus 3, 4.
3 by 36. Okay? Sum of the numbers is less than 12.
Sum of the numbers is less than 12.
Less than 12 means everything. Less than 12 means 1 plus 1, 2. 1 plus 2, 3. 1 plus 3, 4. So you will get 36 by 36, which is nothing but 1. So this type of method of problems are important, children. So I explained one or two problems. You try to solve few more problems so that you will understand this concept. You must understand when we throw two dice at a time, total number of possible outcomes are 36. Sum of the numbers means if you add this and this, that is called sum of the numbers on top of them. Okay, children, this is our 10th question. Now coming to question number 11. From a pack of 52 playing cards,
total number of cards are 52. Jacks, queens, kings and aces of red color are removed. Actually we have 26 red cards, 26 black cards. But what they are saying, they have removed jacks, queens, kings and aces of only red color are removed. So actually we have 13 hearts, 13 diamonds. In 13 hearts we have jack, king, queen, as they are 4 cards. Here also we have 4 cards. Totally 4 plus 4, 8 cards.
8 cards they have removed.
From total how many? Totally we have 52. From that 8 they removed. So total number of outcomes are 42.
Children, did you understand statement number 1? Totally 52 cards. From that they have removed king, queen, jack, ash of red color.
Means totally how many king, queen, jack, ash of red? 8 will be. So total number of outcomes 44.
Now coming to question number 1. A black queen. Find the property that a card drawn is black queen. So 26 are in black color, in that 13 spades, 13 clubs, in this one queen will be. Total number of possible outcomes are, number of possible outcomes we have only 2, because spades one queen, clubs one queen. So probability of an event that is getting a black queen is 2 by 44, 2 banja, 2 20 sura. So answer is what? 1 by 22. Children, did you understand? My question is, find the probability that the card drawn is a black queen. Black queen. Totally, we have 2 black queens. So, number of possible outcomes are 2 and the total number of outcomes are 44. Now, coming to second question, a red card. Probability is what? Getting a red card. Totally, we have 26 red cards. Among them we have removed 8 cards already, because king, queen, jack, ash we removed. 26 minus 18 how much? 18, right? So number of possible outcomes are 18 and total number of outcomes are 44. 2 9 jar, 2 22 jar. So answer is what? 9 by 22, children. Is it clear, children? So in this type of questions you need to understand the question properly. Understanding the question is important. If you understand the question, solution is very easy. Now coming to question number 12. Suppose you drop a dice at random on the circular region of diameter 28 cm as shown in the figure. So this is our circular region. We drop a dice at random on the circular region of diameter 28 cm as shown in the figure. What is the probability that it will land inside the rectangle? So if you observe here, inside the circular region we have a rectangle. So they are asking to find the probability that it may land inside the rectangle. It may land inside the rectangle. Possible outcome is what? Possible outcome is it may land here. Inside the rectangle, which is nothing but what? The region bounded by a closed figure, it is said to be an area. So that is area of rectangle
and total number of possible outcomes means it may land inside the circle, I mean area of circle.
Children, why I wrote? Suppose we drop a die at random of a circular of diameter 28 cm, what is the probability that it may land inside the rectangle? I mean somewhere inside the rectangle means area. Inside means area. So area of rectangle, that is our possible outcome. And total number of outcomes means it may land inside the rectangle or at this region. Area of the circle. Children, what is the area of circle formula? Area of circle is pi r square, right? A equal to pi r square. As we know that pi value 22/7. And the given diameter is what?
Diameter is 28 cm. What about the radius? Radius will be half of the diameter. Means 28/2, 14 cm. Into 14, into 14. 7 1 the 7 2 the. So 22 into 14 2 the 28. 28 into 22, 2 8 the 16, 2 2 the 4 plus 1 5. Again 56. 6 which is equal to 616 square centimeter.
So area of circle is pi r square, which is nothing but 616. So total number of possible outcomes are 616 square centimeter. Now let us find out the area of rectangle. We know that length into breadth. Length is 11 into 7. 11 7 the 77. So which is also square centimeter. Right? Children, did you understand? What is the area of rectangle formula? Length into breadth. 11 into 7. 11 7 the 77. I mean 77/616. Okay children, it may cancel 77/1 the 77/8 the. So the answer is what? 1/8. So probability that it will land inside the rectangle is 1/8. So children, these are the type of problems they are asking in the public examination. Okay, we covered all 2 mark questions, 4 mark questions as well as 8 mark sum. So children, after watching the video, once again you practice these sums so that you'll get easily nearly 15 marks you'll get. Okay children, thank you children.